Hey there. Welcome to Life, Noggin. You know, I think I liked the way I looked before. We should go back to that. As you make your way to the beach this summer, you might want to brush up on your knowledge of one of the ocean's most simple but elegant creatures, the jellyfish. They are comprised of 95% water and have just a basic nervous system that allows them to smell, detect light, and respond to stimuli. But what they lack in heart and brains, they make up for in venom. Each year, about 150 million people around the world are stung by a jellyfish. Sometimes, large numbers of jellyfish are pushed close to the shore by ocean currents, resulting in episodes of mass stingings. Like last summer in Florida, of course, when 800 people were stung in just 3 days. The long tentacles of jellyfish are lined with thousands of stinging cells. Each cell has a hollowed capsule called a nematocyst that contains a tightly coiled, harpoon-like thread that is immersed in venom. When the capsule comes into contact with something like your skin, the thread is released, penetrates into your body, and delivers the venom all in a fraction of a second. The venom contains toxins that can affect your gastrointestinal, cardiac, and neurological systems, and cause allergic reactions. While many types of jellyfish are relatively harmless, and most stings only cause pain and red marks on your skin, there are some types, like the box jellyfish, that are much more dangerous and cause whole body and potentially life-threatening illnesses. These severe stings can cause vomiting, muscle spasms, fainting, difficulty breathing, and heart problems. The box jellyfish is considered to be one of the most venomous and dangerous creatures in the world. Different species of these cube-shaped jellies range in size from 5 millimeters to 3 meters long. Their sting can cause excruciating pain, heart failure, and death within minutes. An estimated 40 people die each year from box jellyfish stings, but some scientists believe this number may be closer to 500. Effective treatment of jellyfish stings depends on the species that stings you, but generally, if you've been stung, you should remove any attached tentacles with tweezers instead of scraping or rubbing them, as pressure releases their venomous capsules. Then, soak the affected area in hot water or vinegar. Severe stings may require CPR, and if it was a box jelly, you may need an antivenom. Recently, scientists have found a potential antidote to box jellyfish stings in the form of cholesterol medication. So far, it's only been tested in mice, but it was able to block pain, tissue death, and scarring for 15 minutes. To avoid getting stung in the first place, scientists have developed topical products that can prevent or reduce their severity. One study found that this type of cream prevented over 80% of jellyfish stings. You can also wear a protective suit or avoid the ocean during jellyfish season. Or maybe we should just avoid the ocean altogether for like, you know, a couple of million years, whatever you want to do. This episode of Life Noggin was sponsored by CuriosityStream, the world's first streaming service addressing our lifelong quest to learn, explore, and understand the world. Founded by John Hendricks, the founder of the Discovery Channel, CuriosityStream has over 2,400 documentaries and nonfiction titles from some of the world's best filmmakers, including exclusive originals. Get unlimited worldwide access starting at just $2.99 a month. And for our audience, your first month is completely free if you sign up at curiositystream.com/lifenoggin and use the promo code LifeNoggin during the sign-up process. If you love learning, which I think you might, click the first link in the description to sign up today. So have you ever been stung by a jellyfish? Do you know anybody that has? What type of creatures do you want us to talk about next? Let me know in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching and liking this video. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.